आर्मी चीफ जनरल एम एम नरवणे इस वक्त क्या कह रहे हैं आपको सुनवा रहे हैं।
अंडरटेकन टू सी व्हाट ऑल ड्यूअल यूज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज देयर व्हिच कैन बी मेड यूज ऑफ व्हिच इज अवेलेबल इन द सिविल डोमेन ऑन द वेस्टर्न फ्रंट अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल आफ्टर हाइटन सिचुएशन फॉर अ लॉन्ग पीरियड द डीजीएम वॉज अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन फेब्रुवरी लास्ट ईयर was aimed at achieving a mutually beneficial and sustainable peace. Resultantly, the situation has seen a marked improvement. But notwithstanding that, there is an increase in concentration of terrorists in various launch pads, and there have been repeated attempts at infiltration across the LC. And needless to say, this once again exposes the nefarious designs of our western neighbor. But we on our part have resolved to show zero tolerance for terror and we have committed ourselves to extract dire costs should that be forced upon us. In Jammu and Kashmir, the whole of government approach has led to a progressive improvement in the security situation. There have been efforts to give an indigenous hue to terrorism by setting up a facade of proxy terror tanzeems, but these attempts have failed miserably and have not got any public support. Various other inimical elements re-energize their attempts at disrupting peace in the valley, mainly by trying to target minorities, non-locals, migrant labor, and so on. However, this also has not succeeded very much, and we have been able to counter these challenges also. In the Northeast, the overall security situation is under control. A robust security posture has significantly curtailed the operation space for terrorists, and in keeping with the improved situation, there has been a graduated de-induction of army units where the situation has improved and they have now free to concentrate on their primary task. On the India-Myanmar border, this is an important facet of our security calculus. Due impetus is being given to the border guarding role by the Assam Rifles. And here we do intend to progressively increase the number of Assam Rifle battalions deployed for border guarding of this very important India-Myanmar border. In the Northeast again, the regrettable incident which happened in Oting in Nagaland on 4th of December is being thoroughly investigated. We remain committed to the security of our countrymen even during the conduct of operations. We have SOPs that encapsulate our operational experience which have been refined over a period of time. And appropriate action will be taken and corrective measures instituted to further refine these, based, of course, on the outcome of the investigations. Overall, in line with our operational realities, we have undertaken reorganization and rebalancing of our forces. Reorientation of additional forces to the northern borders has been carried out, while retaining our capability for punitive strikes on the western front. Force restructuring, which is a very important facet for enhanced operational effectiveness and resultant structural optimization through the creation of integrated battle groups, is proceeding well. The IBGization, if I may call it that, of select formations along the western and northern borders will soon come to fruition. In line with our collective efforts towards greater synergy and integration, for the establishment of Theater Command, we on our part are carrying out our deliberations in consultation with the other two services, in line and keeping in mind the timelines which have been given to us by Headquarter IDS. We, that is the Indian Army, stand fully committed to jointness and synergy. There has also been a sustained and coordinated effort towards capability enhancement. The crisis on the northern borders gave us an opportunity to fast-track our infrastructure development and undertake doctrinal reviews and make up various operational voids which had been existing through emergency and fast-track procurements. While doing all this, the Indian Army, we are committed to the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, and we have prioritized our procurements so that maximum of this should go to the Indian industry. And at the same time, we are also hand-holding numerous indigenization projects, right from the design and development stage, right to the trials and their induction into the army. For example, in the current financial year, out of the 20 AONs which were granted, 19 are in the Buy Indian category. We have also taken very significant steps on leveraging artificial intelligence, 5G, quantum technology to gain an edge over our likely adversaries and for better management of forces. The Indian Army's participation, of course, in various peacekeeping operations worldwide has ensured peace in various parts of the world and has helped us as a nation to carve a niche for ourselves in UN affairs. And as of now, we have more than 5,300 personnel deployed in 8 UN missions in various parts of the globe. Side by side, there has also been a lot of considerable, I would say, increase in the defense cooperation activities that we have been undertaking with our friendly foreign countries. And owing to our high standards of training, professional expertise, and the reliable defense technology that we have, more and more foreign countries have shown interest in engaging with us. And when required, we have walked that extra mile to accommodate the requests, especially from our immediate neighbors. We have also undertaken joint HADR exercises to synergize our efforts and resources. We recently concluded the PANEX 21 exercise for BIMSTEC countries in December 2021 at Pune. And earlier last year, in November, we had the exercise Konkan Shakti with the United Kingdom. And both these exercises were against the backdrop of a pandemic scenario.
जनरल मनोज मुकुंद नरवणे आर्मी चीफ ये जानकारी देते हुए कि किस तरह से सेना की तैयारी है और पिछले एक साल के दौरान क्या कुछ किया गया, किस तरह के हालात रहे, किस तरह की चुनौतियों का सामना करना पड़ा है.
प्रेजेंटिंग बी न्यूज़ ऐप अवेलेबल ऑन गूगल प्ले एंड एप स्टोर. डाउनलोड इट नाउ.